What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying Microsoft Edge WebView 2 using SCCM, which is a continuation on the video that I did with deploying Teams. And when we loaded Teams, the new Teams app, it gave us that problem. So I'm going to show you guys how to deploy with SCCM. So let's get right into it. All right, so where we left off here on the last video. Again, I'll show you guys how to deploy the new Microsoft Teams app within SCCM. When we launched it, we got this, and this is how you will get it up and running within SCCM. You want to deploy this package. You don't want to download it individually. You want to push it out to the masses. To download it, we're going to go to this website, and we're going to scroll down a little bit, and on the middle, we're going to go into the Evergreen Standalone Installer. We're going to click on x64. We're going to accept and download, and then click close, and it's going to start downloading it and dropping it into our downloads folder. Well, it dropped into my downloads folder. Now I'm going to take this exe file and I'm going to move it over to my SCCM server. I have a folder already inside sources, apps, Microsoft Edge WebView 2, and I dropped it into this folder. I'm going to make sure I copy this path because I'm going to be needing it a little later. Now it is time for us to create our application package. So open up your configuration manager, and within here we're going to go into software, and within software let's double click and open up the application management. We're going to go inside applications, and within my system, I already have a bunch of folders, so I'm going to choose Microsoft. You're not going to have these folders. This is just my system, so you could drop it wherever you want. But I'm going to right-click the Microsoft folder, and I'm going to pick Create an Application. From here, I'm going to select Manually Specified the Application Information. Click Next there. I'm going to give it a name and a publisher. And then once I'm done, I'm going to click Next. From here, I'm going to click Next again. So the deployment type, I'm going to click on Add. On this dialog box, I'm going to select Manually Specify the Deployment Type Information and click Next. Give it a name and then click Next here. Now the content location, that's the reason why I copied that network path. So I'm going to paste it there. And the installation program is going to be the following. This is what I'm going to enter. So I'm going to select this. Right-click on it, copy it, and paste it in there. I'm going to click Next. Now, the next thing is the detection method. And this is what I use within my environment. So if you have something better, let me know at the comment section. I'm always willing to learn something new. So from here, I'm going to click on Add Clause. For the setting type, it is going to be a registry. For the Hive, I'm actually going to pick Local Machine. And the key is going to be the following. Now the value is going to be the program W6432DIR. All the Windows machines have this value. And the data type is going to be a string. Now it's actually going to equal to the following value. As long as that is satisfied, the application should go to the next step. And that means to install on the machine. So let's click OK. Click Next here. The installation behavior, I'm going to click on the drop-down menu and I'm going to select Install for System. For the login requirement, I'm going to click on the drop-down and change it to whether or not the user is logged in. And for the installation program visibility, I'm going to change it to Hidden. Click Next here. No requirements, click Next. No dependencies, click Next. A nice little summary, click Next. Green check mark is always a good thing. Click close. Takes you back here, so click Next. Summary, click Next. Completion, and let's close it. Now from here, we're going to right-click our new application, and we're going to pick on Distribute Content. So we're going to click Next here. Next. Click on Add. Select Distribution Point. Select your DP. Click OK. Click Next. Summary, Next. And you're done, so close it. Now, before I do anything, I want to make sure it's green, it's solid, it's distributed. So on the lower right-hand side, click on Content Status. It's going to take you to here. Just make sure on the lower right-hand side, it says Success. It's green. It's good to go. Once all that stuff is done, it is time for us to deploy our package. So again, select your new package, right-click on it, select Deploy, click on Browse. By default, it's showing me the user collection, so click on the drop-down and select device collection. And I'm going to pick the same one that we did before when we installed the new Microsoft Teams app. And that's install new Microsoft Teams, which has only one computer. Click OK. Let's click Next. Next here. The purpose is definitely going to be required. So I'm going to change it. Click Next. For scheduling, I left everything as the default, so click Next. For the user experience, I just made sure I checked off software installation, and I click Next here. For alerts, I left everything as the default, click Next. A nice little summary, click Next, and you're done, and then you close it. Now, if you want to monitor the deployment, you're actually able to go inside the Monitoring tab and go inside Deployments, and then locate your software deployment. If you double click on it, it's going to take you here. What's going to happen? It goes into unknown. If everything works well, it should bypass requirements not met. It should go into in progress. Once it's done, it should go into success. Now, let's go inside that PC. And this is the PC from the old video, the one that we did together when we installed the new Microsoft Teams app. If I open up the command prompt and I do a host name, that's the one. And I also do it at who am I? I'm logged in as administrator. It doesn't really matter. And we're going to go into Control Panel. We're going to do Configuration Manager, go to Actions, and let's select the first one, and let's click on Run Now. Only reason I'm doing this is I want to speed up the process with the SCCM. It's not going to cache in locally for it to install. Give it some time. If you go inside Programs and Features, you're going to see that the Microsoft Edge WebView 2 runtime was installed successfully. Now, if you click on Start, and you locate that Microsoft Teams app and you load it up, it's going to say this and it's going to give you this, which is a good thing. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.